Glendon Hill fronts Sancorp Industries. Sancorp is deep into natural gas. I don't give a hoot about natural gas, but I have 67 deputy whips and they all need cash to win races. Sancorp helps me purchase loyalty, and in return, they expect mine. It's degrading, I know, but when the tit's that big, everybody gets in line.
The reason House of Cards is so popular is that it repeatedly demonstrates how the American political system is broken. Our representatives are focused first on winning elections, and to do that, they need to raise vast amounts of money to run massive campaigns with tons of advertising. They then become beholden to the individuals and companies that finance their elections, rather than focusing on what we need from our government. My name is Sanjaya Punyasena, and I'm one of the founders of Simpolfy, a startup bringing the power back to the people. All of this money is being used for one purpose, to convince you to vote one way or another. In the 2012 election, $7 billion was spent on campaigns. We were all bombarded with ads full of false promises, harsh attacks, contrived slogans, or those that had absolutely no substance and were just gimmicks, but made excellent late-night television material. Your vote is your source of power in our democracy, yet you've diluted that power down to choosing a color, like blue or red, or letting it be influenced by a YouTube video. Instead of picking candidates based on their records, this has all become one big popularity contest, not too different than a high school election. This has gotten us into the political situation we're in. We re-elect incumbents who have done poor jobs, or we replace them with uninspiring challengers who we don't expect to do much better. No matter which side of the political aisle you're on, we all know that our political system is broken. Our Congress is on track to be the least productive Congress ever. We've all become so frustrated, so disillusioned with our political system because it's so hard to hold our representatives accountable. Why spend time trying to stay on top of the issues when it feels like you just can't change anything? Thankfully, a new trend has given us hope: clicktivism. People are willing to click to show their support for an issue, sign a petition, or share content to their social networks. Sites like change.org, We the People, and Move On have shown that if you lower the cost of engagement, millions of people actually engage. Anthea Watson from Google Civic came up with this equation. In a nutshell, it basically calculates your willingness to engage in politics. That the cost to you in time and money needs to be less than the personal benefit to you. Simpolfy is all about getting that cost as small as possible. And we're doing that with three main features. First is a feature like online dating, but for legislation. So like a dating site, we ask you a series of questions so that we can figure out where you stand on issues and where your passions lie. We use that information to tell you which parts of a bill we think you're for, which you're against, and overall, whether we think for or against the bill. Second, we've created the 21st century version of calling or writing your representative. I never understood why we're still being asked to call or write. That's so 21st century. In an age where there's an app that makes everything a button push away, Simpolfy lets you one click to tell your representative which way you want them to vote. You'll even be able to rally your friends to do the same. You'll also be able to verify your identity so that your congressperson knows you're a real constituent holding them accountable. To drive that cost further down, you won't even need to use our site or fire up our app. You can use social media sites like Twitter. If I were to tweet this hashtag, then one of two things would happen. If I have an account, Simpolfy would automatically pull it in and attribute it to my profile. If I don't have an account, Simpolfy will encourage me to sign up for one so that my message goes directly to my representative. This allows users to stay engaged through existing platforms they're using on a regular basis, rather than forcing them to log on to our site. So the third feature is what will be the game changer in politics: your representative's report card. Over the course of the legislator's term, you'll see how well they voted in line with your beliefs. You'll also be able to see how many times you clicked or tweeted asking them to vote a certain way, and how many times they actually voted that way. This has the potential to be significantly more valuable than a traditional calling or writing your congressperson, because with this information right in front of you, it can influence your decision on election day. To get Simpolfy in the hands of every voter, we're launching one issue per month starting now. During the month, we'll ask users a series of questions around that issue so we can see where they stand, but more importantly, where they're willing to compromise. With enough engaged citizens, we can create the framework for legislation that can actually make it through both houses. That is, if your representatives are actually willing to represent you. Then, just maybe, we can solve some of the major issues our country faces, such as the national debt, gun control, immigration, or Social Security. Before I go, I want you all to take a moment. Tell us how you feel about a federal minimum wage of $10.10. Send us a tweet stating whether you're with it or against it. Simpolfy will automatically respond to you, and then you can sign up for an account and help us pave the path to a better democracy with greater civic engagement and increased accountability. Thank you.